Hello and welcome back to Biker Stuff. This is a 1994 Honda CBR900RR. It was brought in because it wouldn't charge the battery. Like the owner, I assumed it was the regulator, rectifier, or possibly the stator. He told me he had fitted a new regulator, but this has made no difference. I asked if he had a new stator, and when he brought the bike in, he gave me one. When I removed the seat, the electrics looked like they had been worked on. I removed the wrapping and found it had been rewired and was now degrading and falling apart. So, my plan to show you how to test for a regulator and rectifier and the stator has temporarily fallen flat. And I have now rewired the charge system, and it appears to all be working okay. However, I will show you the test to do and what to look out for. What I'm going to do is explain the system and then show you over two videos how to test both parts. This is how the charge system works on motorbikes generally, and specifically on the CBR. The stator has three AC phases on it, which sends the power up three yellow wires into the regulator rectifier. The rectifier then takes the AC charge, converts it to DC, and passes it to the regulator. The regulator does exactly what it says on the tin, and keeps the voltage at a level the battery can handle. In this case, up to 14.5 volts. Today, I'll show you how to test a typical regulator rectifier as used on motorbikes. You can do this test on or off the bike. We will perform a static test on the rectifier without the engine running, and a test on the regulator connected to the bike with the engine running afterwards. Start by disconnecting the plug that goes into the regulator rectifier, which is on the CBR900 under the right hand rear side panel. You don't need to remove it from the bike, but it can make the tests easier. You will see three pins at the top and one either side on the bottom. The three at the top will come from the stator. The lower left one is positive and the bottom right is negative. To make the testing easier, I'm changing the probe on my lead to a crocodile clip. You'll need your meter set up to 20 kilo ohms for this test. Start by connecting the black lead to the lower left pin, positive, then touch the red lead onto the three upper pins in turn and check the results. In each case, you should get a result of 0.5 to 10 ohms. Next, change your leads over. Clip the red lead onto the lower right pin and do the test again and look to get the same results. Brilliant. If you get that don't give the expected results. This means you have a diode failure and your rectifier needs replacing. Next, we'll test the regulator. This will require the system being put back on the bike and wired up. Start the engine and get it warmed up. That has warmed the engine. To start this test, connect your meter to the battery. It should read between 12 and 13 volts, but may differ depending on the type of battery you have. Set your meter to 20 volts. Start the engine and you should see the volts rise to about 14 to 14 and a half volts. And that is how you test the regulator. I hope you found it interesting. Thank you for watching. You know you liked it, so tell your friends to like and subscribe. Don't forget to click on the bell to get notifications when there is more from Biker Stuff. I do love to read your comments and emails, so keep them coming.